In the last mailbag, you might remember me saying the postman's been working overtime and you might have, and I got so much stuff, and you might have been thinking that was hyperbole. Here we go again. It's mailbag weekend. Let's get into it. This time I'm going to start with the biggest one. We'll see what it says. It says lights on it, and a package this size could mean a couple of things. Let's see. Aha! I recognize that type of package. It says warm white on it. I'm gonna guess it's more of the same kind of lights I got up there, except for obviously warm white. There we go. Okay. Oh, those are a little bit different size of LED. The ones that are up above the bench are these ones. And the one that just showed up are that. Hey, where did that ruler go? Okay, so where's my millimeter scale? So the ones that I'm using up above me here, okay, there. 4 millimeters by 2 millimeters, oh, 204 maybe. These ones, is that 2 or 3 millimeters by about 5? I don't know, I'll look it up in the description. Okay, so these ones, they look like they are 3 LEDs per section, per segment, plus a resistor, whereas the ones that I, the bright white ones that I'm using up above here are 4 LEDs and no resistor per segment. Just going to quickly strip these back a little bit more than they already are. All right, so I got these guys hooked up to my 12 volt power supply here. Well, variable power supply. Set it to 12 volts and 3 amps, which is the maximum this thing can do. Doink! Wow, that's bright. 12 volts and it's drawing 2.9. Oh wow, it's pretty much current limiting just right around 3 amps. Wow, that's bright. Hmm. I wonder if I want to add any of that to my lighting up here. Huh. They're getting warm. Not stupid hot. Well, I mean, there's 3 amps being drawn through them. Does it say on the package how much is on that reel? 5 on there. Could it be 5 meters? Maybe. Anyways, we'll go take a look at the listing. From Banggood, the 5 meter warm white 5630 SMD non-waterproof 12 volt LED strip. So it was 5 meters, I was right. $5.75 free shipping. To do 5 meters per reel, 300 LEDs per 5 meters, 3M double-sided adhesive tape. Well, it's M, it says M on the back anyway, it doesn't actually say 3M. There we go. All right, next thing in, electronic components. It's a module with no name on it. You just slightly poked through the plastic of the static bag, but it hasn't gotten bent or anything. Okay. Let's see what it is. No. So, oh, it's getting closer here. Can I see through the camera what this is? Not really. Oh, LM386. It's an amplifier. Looks to be a variable. Here's something to fiddle this. Looks like it's a variable amplification amplifier. Ground in, presumably signal, and VCC, and a ground in and out. Okay. Clearly, I'm going to have to look at the listing to find out anything more about this guy. The LM386 audio amplifier module, 200 times 5 volt to 12 volt, 10K adjustable resistance. Oh, whoopee, it uses a 10K pot on it. Okay, $121 Canadian from Gowin Electronic, all the way from Shenzhen, China, free shipping. Is there any more specs down here? He uses an LM386 chip, 200 multiplier benefit, speaker wiring block, 10K variable resistor. You can adjust the volume of the enlarged. Ooh, adjusting the volume of the enlarged. Very nice. Power indicator. The chip pin leads can be directly input. Audio signal. 5 volts, 12 volts, board size, yada, yada, yada. Okay. Okay, what is this one? Getting with the Canada Post sticker right over top of it. It is, oh, some little switches. Okay, double pull, double throw switches on. So basically, it has two on positions. You can use it just as an on-off, or the center pin is the wiper that bounces between these other two contacts. So when the switch is in that direction, these two pins are tied together. When it's in that position, those two are tied together. But if you omit using one of those, you can just use it as an on-off switch. Neat. And what do we got here? Bag of five of them. Cool. Five pieces of SPDT switch. 6 amp, 125 volts AC. Never gonna use it to switch line voltage, that's for sure. Anyway, from World Chips, it was $1.77 and it was an auction. Alright, next, emergency button. That's intriguing. Oh, it even says Oh, I remember this. This was another late night, kind of on a whim. Actually, it might have even been an auction. It's an industrial switch. Good. One, two, three, four. So this on industrial equipment, this is the kind of a switch that you'd literally put on as an emergency stop for the equipment. You twist it in the direction of the arrows. And it pops up, and that turns on what's going on in there. Let's just get the meter in. So right now it's in the on position. So that switch is closed, and that switch is open. So the red one's closed and the yellow one's open, orange, whatever. But if it's an emergency, you just smack it, presumably on your way out the door, and now that one is closed. And that one's open. So normally, this one, the one that opens when you smack it, would have the power to your equipment going through it. And this one that closes would have some kind of an alarm circuit or something like that, or a sensing circuit going on. I have no real use for an industrial component like this, but what I thought might be cool is if I was to mount it on my railroad so that it is interrupting the track power. Come on, screw back on there, you. So that it interrupts the track power when you whack it, just as an emergency stop for the railroad. Completely silly and pointless because because on my control system, there is an emergency stop button right on the throttles on the handhelds. But I think this just looks cool. And it was probably really cheap, otherwise I wouldn't have bought it.
600 volt AC 10 amp red mushroom cap. One normally open, one normally closed. DPST, double pole single throttle, emergency stop button push switch, aka the big red button. Because why wouldn't you want a big red button? This one's from 94 Racing-US, even though it was actually from Guangzhou, China. And it was $1.65 Canadian with free shipping all the way from China. Does it say very much else about it that we didn't figure out before? Color as shown, self-locking action, one normally open and one normally closed. They claim 660 volts, 10 amps. Yeah, right, I'm going to be using it with 12 volts maximum. For a 22 millimeter hole, panel thickness 6 millimeters, size, yeah. Four terminals, red mushroom emergency stop latching switch with yellow cap. Oh, that's the ring around it that says emergency stop. Easy to use and install. Yes. And there it is in all its big red button glory.
Okay, what's next here? Oh, it's a gift. Isn't that nice? A gift from our friends in China. Shaped little circuit board in that package. What are you? You're jammed in the bag. Okay, we got a micro USB. Got a little rocker switch. A little three position switch and LED. Hang on. This would be a lot easier. There we go. So, micro USB, rocker switch, this way, that way, three position switch, LED, looks like a little microphone, and a micro SD slot. Oh, there's a Klues SP plus and minus speaker. Possibly 5 volts power. I wonder if that's some kind of an MP3 player, maybe. With a microphone? Huh. Gonna have to look that guy up.
3.7 to 5 volt Bluetooth audio receiver amplifier module, precise MP3 decoder. As opposed to the other kind, I guess. From GC Supermarket. Bought a fair number of things from them over the years. Oh wait, $3.30 Canadian, 2.70 American. Let's see what it has to say for itself down below here. The specs: Bluetooth description, Bluetooth 2.1 plus EDR, transmission power class 2, Bluetooth protocol, blah 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 blah, and hands-free profile. If you're into studying the Bluetooth specification, that will mean all kinds of things to you. For the rest of us, whatever. Transmission distance about 10 meters in open area. That's ambitious for Bluetooth in my experience. Supply voltage, somewhere between 3.7 and 5 volts. So 3.7 volts. Oh, 18650, here we come. Or 5 volts, everything else in the world. But the only power connection I could find comes in through the USB over here. So I can't see myself. Oh, wait a minute. It's got a V plus and a V minus pad on the board. It looks like there. I'll have to look at the real one. Anyway, output power 3 watts or 4 Euro horns. I've never heard of the unit Eurohorn. I'll have to Ask somebody, I guess. Signal to noise radio ratio greater than or equal to 70 dB. Frequency response 100 kilo or 100 hertz to 18 kilohertz. Well, that's not going to do your big bass any favors. But for Bluetooth, that's not bad. You don't use Bluetooth if you're going to be caring about high fidelity, that's for sure.
All right, now that we've looked at it on the listing and we know that it is in fact a Bluetooth speakerphone, MP3 player, etc. And since it's also got an SD card on there, I've got my handy dandy little SD card from the Don't Sue Me library. So, power. Power light comes on. Little power light. Speaker plus and speaker minus, I've got connected to this big honking speaker over here. So, let's see what happens if I plug in an SD card. Nothing. Okay, let's see what happens if I switch that way. Haha, music. Let's see now this thing. Volume. Tap it and it skips tracks. And hold it and it seems to volume. Well, that's neat. Okay. So, here's the MP3 player function. Short song, sorry. Okay. That seems to be a kind of an off position. So, since it claims to be a Bluetooth speaker. Oh ho! Okay. Let's get a Bluetooth device in here and see what I can find. Scanning, scanning, scanning. Oh, I found a device. Pairing. Connected for calls and media. Okay. Well, this tablet can't do calls, but it can definitely do media. What did I poke? Let's just play this one. That's coming out of here. Aw. This tune that everybody uses? Can't do that. I don't know who he is. That's not part of the copyright-free music. I don't want to want. Copyright-free music library. Quickly. Poke something. There we go. Okay. And okay, so if I do that, I guess since I'm not playing off the MP3 player function in there, but still, that's cool. I don't have any MP3s loaded on that one, so I can't try that function, but it can definitely do music from there. That's awfully neat. I like it. I'm not sure what I'm going to use it for. Maybe I'll make my own, I'll make my own Bluetooth thing for the car. That's what I'll do. It'll probably be better than the one that I've got in my work truck, which sounds like hell. The important part, I think, when you're installing one of these in a vehicle, is to make sure that microphone is somewhere close to your skull. The idiots that installed the one in my work truck installed it down by the steering column in an echo chamber around, and nobody can hear what the hell I'm saying. So if I'm going to do this in my car, I'm going to do this properly. Plus then we got Bluetooth tunes and MP3s rather than the cheesy old AM radio that's in the car from the factory. Okay. Man, did I ever digress. Time for the next mailbag item. Electronic parts. Well, that's deja vu. Didn't I just... Yeah. Same part number and everything. Okay, I guess there's not much to say about those. They're switches.
More switches. Also $1.77 Canadian. Also an auction. Presumably I was bidding on both auctions, assuming that I'd only win one of them or maybe none of them. But I won them both. This set of identical switches to the other ones was from CZB672196 0EIEIO. Also in Shenzhen, China, free shipping. No need to look at the specs because we've already seen them.
And the last item for today. It says on the back here, nothing. Oh, it says LED module there. Okay. So I guess it's probably an LED module. Any bets? Is it really an LED module? Oh, it has LEDs on it. But it also has a big couple of 5-watt, 7.5-ohm resistors. That looks like a battery test load or discharge test load or something like that. I remember ordering one, and if I remember correctly, there we go. Resistors go across the outside in parallel, I guess, to create a load, and the input voltage goes there, and 5 volts goes over there on the USB. Okay. Let's try it out on something. Okay, so 3.9495. Okay. I have an okay, a plus, and a minus button here. Let's just... P... Okay. Okay, so now it's showing... Volts is 3.6, amp hours is 0.0, amps is 0.4 something. Okay, 3.6. So I'm guessing what I was setting before for 3.0 is the voltage that it stops at, 0.3 amp hours. Okay, so I'm going to have to let this guy buck for a while. That's not getting hot. I guess I'll just have to let that run for a while. Okay, I was starting to get a bit impatient, so I put the second resistor in there. So now it's discharging at a rate of 800 milliamps. And it's, so that should blast a little faster. And yeah, I did a bit more reading, and the plus and minus buttons are for setting the stop voltage at. So it basically just cruises along here until it hits the stop voltage, which was set for 3 volts. Oh. And there we are. So. Wow. 13 milliamp hours was what it took to discharge that battery. Which makes sense because it wasn't really fully charged anyway. That works pretty well, doesn't it? Just a piece of... anti-static bag. Anyway, that's an aside. Okay. So I like that. That's going to be a useful thing around here. Especially when I get to stripping out some battery packs to see just how good the lithium-ion batteries that I'm getting out of them are. 1860 lithium-ion lithium lead acid battery capacity meter discharge tester analyzer. $4.07, or $3.33 American, from Shenglong Seoul, sure. Free shipping from, my font doesn't do that, China. Okay, so I've gone to a different listing because that one didn't have very much information in it.
just to try and find some information about it. So, tester discharge type 1.2 to 12 volt, and other tests 18650, because that's just a keyword. Toggle single function by controlling the load off and get real-time integrated discharge current capacity results. Maximum support 15 volt 3 amps. That's an important thing. Maximum statistics 9,999 amp hours, or 1,000 times that, milliamp hours. Specs: power supply voltage 4.5 to 6 volts from the micro USB, 70 milliamps on that side. Discharge voltage 1 to 15 volts in 0.01 volt resolution steps, I guess. Terminal voltage, that's the ending of the discharge voltage range, which you can set with the plus and minus keys. Anywhere between 0.5 volt and 11 volts, depending on what kind of battery you're discharging. And it will discharge up to 3 amps at a time, or 3 amp load. With those two 7.5 ohm resistors in parallel with each other, I'm guessing that 3 amps is going to max out at the 15 volts if it's discharging a lead acid battery or something. Maximum battery capacity range 9,999 amp hours. We saw that up above. Size, blah, blah, blah. Okay. First test should be a fully charged battery. Connect the battery to the positive and negative. Do not reverse. The load connected to the output positive and negative load side. Push the OK button to make it start testing. And it can automatically develop an appropriate termination voltage of the battery, full charge voltage. Okay, I guess if it is a fully charged battery, you can guess the chemistry. That's interesting. I think I'd rather tell it. Or you can adjust the end voltage with the plus or minus buttons in 0.1 volt steps. That's nice. After the start of the test, the tester will control the load and the test data will scroll. Amp hour and discharge current and battery voltage between the wheel was. I love these machine translations. They're so awesome. When the battery voltage reaches set cutoff voltage, the load control switches off the tester. Okay, cool. Oh, and it has error codes too. I'm going to have to save this one for future reference.
And there's today's mailbag goodies. Quite a useful and random assortment of stuff. I like it. Thanks for watching.